Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansong. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Thursday, the 22nd of April. India records world's biggest single-day rise in coronavirus cases. Taliban's unwillingness delayed peace summit in Istanbul, says Afghan parliament speaker. And Sri Lanka Archbishop criticizes government over Easter attacks probe. And now for all the details. India marked a grim milestone in the COVID-19 pandemic on Thursday, reporting 314,835 new daily cases, the highest one-day tally anywhere, as its second wave and similar surges elsewhere raised new fears about the ability of health services to cope. India's total cases are now at 15.93 million. India reported on Thursday 314,835 new cases of the coronavirus over the previous 24 hours, the highest daily increase recorded anywhere, as its second wave and similar surges elsewhere in the world raised new fears about the virus. India's total cases are now at 15.93 million, while deaths rose by 2,104 to reach a total of 184,657. Hospitals across northern and western India, including capital New Delhi, have issued notices to say they have only a few hours of medical oxygen required to keep COVID-19 patients alive. Several private and government hospitals in the national capital are running low on medical oxygen for COVID-19 patients.
Demand for oxygen has gone up significantly. We have at least 350 COVID patients, and all of them require oxygen. Oxygen varying from 5 liters to 15 liters to even more. So that is the kind of demand that is there at the moment. And because of which, the supplies that are coming in, which are very irregular and uncertain, there is a lot of tension in the system.
Although the centre raised Delhi's oxygen quota, several hospitals are struggling to replenish oxygen supply.
Delhi सरकार ने अपना एक estimation लगाया, जिसके हिसाब से दिल्ली को रोजाना 700 टन ऑक्सीजन की जरूरत है। केंद्र सरकार ने हमारा कोटा कल तक 378 टन तय किया हुआ था। ये कोटा कल शाम को बढ़ा के 480 टन कर दिया है केंद्र सरकार ने। इसके लिए हम केंद्र सरकार के बहुत बहुत आभारी हैं। हालांकि हमें अभी और भी काफी ऑक्सीजन चाहिए।
India has launched a vaccination drive, but only a tiny fraction of the population has had the shots. Authorities have announced that vaccines will be available to anyone over the age of 18 from May 1, but India won't have enough shots for the 600 million people who will become eligible, experts say.
In news from Pakistan, the Pakistan People's Party chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari has said that Prime Minister Imran Khan is turning people hostile against the government by providing patronage to the inflation mafia, adding that the promised Ramadan package is nowhere to be seen. The remark comes as despite Khan's recent promise to supervise inflation in the country, inflation has risen.
Pakistan People's Party Chairman Bilawal Bhutto Zardari has said that Prime Minister Imran Khan is turning people hostile against the government by providing patronage to the inflation mafia, adding that the promised Ramadan package is nowhere to be seen. As reported by local media, Bilawal said that increase in prices of flour and other essential food items shows the incompetence of the PTI government. The remark comes as Imran Khan had promised he will himself supervise inflation in the country, but the rising inflation along with coronavirus pandemic has muted the celebrations for the ongoing holy month of Ramadan. Markets during Ramadan usually witness a great number of visitors who shop a lot as part of the celebrations, but this year markets appear empty.
Moving on, at least 5 people were killed and 11 wounded in a car bombing that ripped through a luxury hotel's parking area in Pakistan's Quetta city on Wednesday. The Chinese envoy to Pakistan was staying at the hotel, but authorities said he was not there at the time of the explosion. The Pakistan Taliban claimed responsibility for the attack. A bomb ripped through a luxury hotel car park in Quetta city of Pakistan's Balochistan province on Wednesday, killing at least 5 people and wounding 11. China's ambassador to Pakistan was staying at the Serena Hotel, but authorities said he was not there when the bomb exploded. The Pakistan Taliban claimed responsibility for the bombing, saying that a suicide bomber carried out the attack with a car full of explosives, but it was not clear if the Chinese envoy was the target. Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan on Thursday expressed his condolences on Twitter and said the country will not allow this scourge of terrorism to rise again.
He was not here at that time. So, इसमें क्योंकि होटल है, आपको पता है, क्वेटा का एक वाहिद फाइव स्टार होटल है, तो उसमें मेहमान तो रहते ही हैं, लेकिन कोई इस वक्त जो है अंदर एम्बेसडर साहब मौजूद नहीं।
बलूचिस्तान इज होम टू न्यूली एक्सपेंडेड ग्वादर डीप वाटर पोर्ट दैट इज की टू अ प्लान्ड multi-billion-dollar इन्वेस्टमेंट इन चाइनाज बेल्ट एंड रोड इनिशिएटिव. Chinese nationals and their interest in the region have been attacked before by Taliban militants and nationalist insurgents who oppose Pakistan's rule. In news from Afghanistan, Speaker of the Volisi Jirga, the lower house of Afghanistan's parliament, Mir Rahman Rahmani, has said the Taliban's unwillingness led to postponement of the UN-led peace conference on Afghanistan to be held in Turkey. The conference was scheduled to take place on April 24, but now it has been postponed because of no participation by the Taliban.
The Speaker of the Volesi Jirga, the lower house of Afghanistan's parliament, Mir Rahman Rahmani, on Wednesday said that the Taliban's unwillingness led to the postponement of the UN-led peace conference on Afghanistan to be held in Turkey. Rahmani said the Istanbul conference is a historic opportunity for the Taliban, the government and the people of Afghanistan, which shouldn't be wasted. The UN-led Afghan peace conference in Turkey was scheduled to take place on April 24, but now the summit has been postponed because of non-participation by the Taliban. Turkey, the UN, the US and Qatar made several attempts in the past to convince the Taliban to ensure their participation in the conference, but the efforts did not yield an outcome. Turkish Foreign Minister Mevlut Cavusoglu on Wednesday tweeted that the conference had been postponed for after the Eid al-Fitr. The Taliban have been insisting that the US first needs to implement the Doha Agreement before the start of the Istanbul conference, meaning that the US needs to honor its agreement signed under the Trump administration to withdraw all US troops from Afghanistan by May 1.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Nepalese Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli and political rival from his own party Madhav Kumar Nepal on Thursday held talks for the second time in a bid to save their party's unity. Both the leaders held a dialogue earlier on Wednesday also, breaking months of deadlock amid political uncertainty. Tensions have been running high in the ruling Nepal Communist Party following differences between the Oli Madhav factions within the party.
Nepal's Prime Minister KP Sharma Oli held second dialogue with a major political rival from his own party, Madhav Kumar Nepal, on Thursday in a bid to save their party's unity. Thursday's meeting was the second dialogue of the two senior leaders of the ruling Nepal Communist Party at Marriott Hotel, based in the national capital Kathmandu, as they held their first meeting on Wednesday, breaking months of deadlock amid political uncertainty. Although the meetings between Oli and Nepal were said to have ended on a positive note, none of the two sides has revealed what transpired in the meetings.
दुई ठूला नेताहरु मिल्यो भने देशको लागि पनि सबैको लागि राम्रो
के संकेत
तपाईँ वार्तामा हुनुहुन्थ्यो भित्र उहाँ संवादमा हुनुहुन्थ्यो
के संकेत पाउनु भयो
वार्ता तब दुई जना निस्किँदाखेरि यसो प्रफुल्ल मुद्रामा खुशी मुद्रामा निस्केको तपाईहरुले पनि हेर्नु
टेन्सन्स have been running high in the ruling party, which is at the brink of a split, following never-ending differences between the factions within the party. While the Madhav Kumar Nepal faction has been running parallel committees in the party, Oli has been issuing suspension notices and threats of permanent expulsion to the members of disgruntled group.
In news from Sri Lanka, on the second anniversary of the Easter attacks, the head of Sri Lanka's Catholic Church has accused the government of stalling investigations into Easter Sunday bombings, saying he was deeply saddened by the lack of progress in the investigation. Nearly 200 people were arrested within days of their suicide attacks on hotels and churches by Islamist extremists, but no one has yet been charged.
The head of Sri Lanka's Roman Catholic Church on Wednesday accused the government of stalling investigations into Easter Sunday bombings 2 years ago that killed 279 people. Nearly 200 people were arrested within days of the attacks on hotels and churches, but no one has yet been charged. Archbishop of Colombo, Cardinal Malcolm Ranjit, who led commemorations on the second anniversary on Wednesday, said he was deeply saddened by the lack of progress in the investigation. The event took place amid restrictions on gatherings to prevent the spread of the coronavirus.
We have to stress that what is happening at the moment, which is an attitude of no care, where all the factors are not properly investigated in a coordinated and an organized fashion, but from day to day according to each day's fortunes, is not going to satisfy our questions.
The blast claimed by militant group Islamic State targeted 3 churches and 3 luxury hotels, shocking the country and shattering a decade of relative peace after the end of a 25-year civil war. St. Sebastian Church in Negombo and St. Anthony's Shrine in Colombo were 2 of the churches targeted, while the Cinnamon Grand Hotel and the Shangri-La Hotel were also badly hit in the attacks. The attacks were carried out despite Indian intelligence giving detailed information about the impending attacks to Sri Lankan authorities nearly 3 weeks ahead of time. A presidential commission has recommended the prosecution of dozens of senior government officials and the then president Maithripala Sirisena for criminal negligence.
In a humane gesture, the Sikh community in Indian capital New Delhi is preparing langar or free food for COVID-19 patients and their families, as the city remains under a week-long lockdown. Members of the management body of Delhi Sikh Shrine said they consider it their responsibility to arrange food for the people who are unable to cook or arrange a meal for themselves.
In a noble gesture, Sikhs in Indian capital New Delhi are preparing langar or free food for the COVID-19 patients and families who are facing a crisis of food scarcity as the city remains under a week-long lockdown. The members of DSGMC, the Delhi Sikh Gurdwara Management Committee, have issued toll-free helpline numbers where the patients can contact and get free food after producing the COVID-19 positive report. Volunteers, including both men and women, were seen preparing and packing food on a mass scale at the city's famous Gurdwara Bangla Sahib on Wednesday.
And I understand that this is the responsibility of the Gurdwara committee, that those positive people who can't make roti in their homes, who can't buy their food outside and can't buy their food, वो लोगों के लिए हमने यह सुविधा शुरू की है कि पैक फूड यहाँ से जाएंगे और ये कोविड पॉजिटिव के लिए है. जो लंगर की प्रथा हमारी चल रही है वो अलग चल रही है, मगर ये कोविड पॉजिटिव के लिए जो पेशेंट्स आएंगे, जो परिवार होंगे, उनको ये लंगर पहुंचाने का काम हमने ये शुरू किया.
The city of 20 million reported over 85,360 active COVID-19 cases as of Thursday. Last year, India's religious and charitable mega kitchens fed thousands of people, mostly migrant workers, who faced a crisis of food scarcity as the country remained under a complete lockdown.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.